Hello, and thanks so much for watching Proactive New York. I'm Christine Corrado. With me right now is Anthony Ginsberg, co-creator of the Han GINS Tech Megatrend Equal Weight ETF. Anthony, good to see you. How are you?
Good morning, Christine. Great, thanks.
Good to hear. Anthony, lots has gone on this year already. Can you maybe talk a bit about the fastest growing tech sectors for 2021 and companies that are within the ETF?
Yes, it's actually been a remarkable last 12 months. A lot of the tech sectors have actually been fast-tracked, Christine, as you can imagine, during COVID. So we've seen things like digital entertainment having their best year in the last 12 months. We've also seen cloud computing become really a mainstream phenomenon, and more IT businesses and companies generally are spending money on cloud and actually dumping their hardware expenditures. So we're seeing a huge wave there. Other areas are gene editing, which is also known as gene sequencing. And that has been one of the fastest re-ratings of any sector that we've seen. So that was up last year, just almost 70-odd%. And I would just mention things like blockchain, which is the underpinning of a lot of, not just cryptocurrency, but other international payments with online ledgers. That last year was up over 100% as well. So there's been a number of areas that have been re-rated. We're also very, very positive on online gaming. Asia Pacific is actually the fastest growing in the spaces of online streaming, online gaming. In fact, it's bigger than Hollywood today. Many people don't realize, but the online gaming world is actually three times larger than Hollywood. So we're pretty positive, you know, across the board. I would also mention robotics and AI. With COVID, there's increasing usage of digital technology and robotics. And also with the US-China trade issues, there's more onshoring to the US, and robotics can actually save manufacturers up to 50% or more expenditure. So look out for robotics and AI also this year.
And you mentioned digital entertainment. Someone like me, I'm hoping to get back to concerts in person. But what you're saying is this kind of second wave of the coronavirus will essentially make something like digital technology kind of permanent right now. So can you kind of explain that a bit more?
Yes, what actually happened with online gaming. In the old days, one would actually have to go and buy your CDs. Today, a lot of it's being generated via the cloud. The cloud really underpins a lot of what we're seeing in the digital revolution. When you come to the online streaming, obviously we have the likes of Netflix, we have other folks like Disney Plus, HBO Max. They're all scaling up primarily through cloud. And the same is now true. It doesn't get as much attention, but my kids who do a lot of online gaming, they're using the cloud. It's a lot cheaper. And increasingly, we've seen the growth last year blew the numbers out. It was actually the best year ever for that space. I think what surprises people also is just how fast Asia Pacific in particular is dominating that space. So actually of all the revenues last year in online gaming, half of it came from Asia Pacific. So it's no longer just the US and perhaps parts of Europe. We're actually seeing the developing world really come on stream very fast, particularly in cloud computing as well, Christine.
And how about adoption rates in the U.S. in addition to Asia Pacific?
Yeah. So the U.S., what's happened is more than 50% of IT expenditure predicted this year will be in remote technologies, particularly things like cloud. Work from home during the second spike, it basically embedded this whole mainstream nature of cloud. So I think some folks thought, okay, we may go back to our regular lives. But what with this lasting almost 12 months, we've just celebrated the first anniversary, unfortunately, with the deaths in the US. Increasingly, people are working from home on a regular, consistent basis now. And it seems like many companies are going to allow their employees to work at least 2, 3, 4 days a week from home. So we are actually expecting the cloud expenditure, the IT and R&D expenditure to increasingly move remotely. We've actually seen some of the biggest numbers in cloud just very quickly. IBM, as you know, made their largest acquisition about a year and a half ago in the multi-cloud world. And that means that a lot of the Fortune 500s can now share data across multiple clouds. They no longer have to just select one cloud provider. So that's reducing the risk. And lastly, I just mentioned cybersecurity is also a fast-growing area. It's pretty much tied to the hip with the cloud companies. So the more cloud does well, the more we're seeing, due to remote issues, that cybersecurity companies are increasingly amongst our top 10 performers in December alone. Five of them basically were in the cyberspace, cybersecurity.
Well, speaking about performance, how had the ETF performed in 2020?
Yeah, it was up 60%, Christine, last year. The biggest weightings there that performed well were future cars, up about 70%. Obviously, Tesla has powered it. We actually remain a bull on Tesla. We believe Tesla is sort of a robot on wheels, actually. We used to think that robots would look like us, but actually increasingly it looks like a car. And they have a much wider moat than many expected, because Volkswagen and BMW and the other players are really quite far behind in their software technology. So we're very bullish on future cars. The other big boosters last year were digital entertainment. That did almost 100% in our ETF. And blockchain, as well as cloud, all boosted it. And the other sleeper there really was probably cybersecurity and gene editing too. We actually equally weight, as you know, these 8 sub-themes. So we're not taking a particular bet on one versus the other. So we're really trying to give clients a broad digital revolution exposure. And of course, every year another one's going to pop up and be the best performer. But we're trying to really say that this is all interrelated. A lot of these areas, including robotics, benefit from the cloud. We know Tesla, their own car, is utilizing a cloud technology to create upgrades remotely for them. So increasingly, this whole ecosystem is one and the same. I don't think one should separate them as much as others sometimes talk about them as being individual parts. Increasingly, they're all benefiting and feeding off one another.
Yeah, I feel like every other day I see another kind of technological update coming from Tesla. It's really remarkable. But Anthony, it's always great to hear your thoughts on this. Thanks so much.
Thanks, Christine. Have a good day.